needs to act now. And the travel and tourism industry has a major role to play. Many of you are already well underway. And I believe that this will lead to many new business opportunities and many more new jobs. Right now, ecotourism is still quite new to many people. But imagine the future market as consumers become more and more informed and more demanding. I can only congratulate those companies that have already started to develop in this direction. The next generation, I'm sure, is already much more aware of the ecological impact we make. And the generation after that will be even more aware. Someday there will be no other way to spend our holiday than in an ecologically friendly way. This is the essence of the eco-efficient economy that we are promoting on a European level and from which many of you already make your living. I very much appreciate the theme that you have chosen for your symposium tomorrow, to make a contribution to the Davos process on climate change and tourism. The Swedish travel and tourism industry has increased by more than 53% at current prices since 2000. And in 2008, the total turnover of the Swedish travel and tourism industry reached 244 billion Swedish crowns. Tourism is important for job opportunities in all parts of our country. As a result of the current economic crisis, employment is falling within many key industries. This is not the case for the travel and tourism industry, in which employment is rising. The full-time job have increased by 20% since 2000, and now almost 160,000 people work full-time in the travel and tourism industry. Sweden wants to welcome people from all over the world, groups, families, friends, singles, business travelers, as well as those who come for pleasure. We want to share our country's beautiful nature and culture with you. And we want to constantly develop more attractive experiences and reasons for you to come. The aim of the Swedish tourism policy is for Sweden to be a highly attractive tourist destination and for tourists to be competitive in the long term. Tourism should contribute to sustainable growth and increased employment throughout the country. But by stimulating travel, we also contribute to climate change. There is an inherent conflict within the travel and tourist industry, as in many other industries. So what can we do? Well, we must do everything we can to combine the positive growth and developing spirit in this sector with environmentally friendly development, so people can come here for pleasure or business also in the future. We should also take care that we do not bite the hand that feeds us when developing the tourist industry. Instead, we must ensure that we take care of our beautiful environment, that it remains for many generations to come. Environmentally friendly travel must be sought within the framework of international cooperation and regulations. We cannot only rely on travelers to be conscious and responsible in the way they travel. The various operators within the travel and tourism industry also have a real responsibility to adapt. Airlines, shipping companies, car rental companies, hotels and restaurants, sports, culture or conference organizers can, by putting tough demands on their suppliers, push the development and thus also protect their own interests. Ecotourism initiatives must be promoted and developed, and every company in the supply chain can step by step improve its products and services in a sustainable and eco-efficient way. I also think that a crucial point is to cooperate much more to get a more efficient transport system with less emissions. Otherwise, it will not be possible for people to travel. The travel and tourism industry is becoming more and more important for our economy. We have a lot to offer visitors from all over the world. We have a unique flora and fauna, mountains in the north, lakes and woods everywhere. We have a pleasant temperature in the summer. We have a winter and snow. Local ecological food production, creative cuisine, culture and sport attractions, and well-designed conference centers and hotels. And in terms of accessibility, our use of the design for all approach means that our public attractions and transportation systems are available for children, elderly, and for disabled. Through our national tourist organization, Visit Sweden, we have a close and fruitful collaboration with travel and tourist companies. Visit Sweden is jointly owned by the Swedish government and by Swedish tourist industry. The Swedish travel and tourist companies want to develop attractive destinations together and therefore invest in Visit Sweden. This model works so well, so we have just announced, or I announce it right now, that we will give more money to Visit Sweden. In the budget we will present on next Monday, we will announce that we will give 50 more million Swedish crowns to Visit Sweden. And we do it because they're doing a great job, not because we are kind. It's because they're doing a great job and they develop their industry very good in Sweden. So we give it because they are good, nothing else. And I hope, I must say, I hope that many of you are sitting here also find that you can cooperate with Visit Sweden and also develop new attractions from Sweden. The Swedish Agency for Economic and Regional Growth is also a supportive actor for the Swedish travel and tourism industry. It is responsible for statistics on tourists and shares information and knowledge about the development of tourists and the travel and tourist industry in Sweden. As an owner and manager of many attractions, such as national parks, historic monuments and infrastructure, the public sector has a significant impact on the travel and tourist industry's development opportunities. Public-owned attractions, products and services must be at the forefront and serve as a role model for the environment and thus stimulate green thinking in all activities they offer. Across Europe, the transformation to an eco-efficient economy is already underway. When I talk to business leaders, it is clear that they are far ahead of us politicians. They have realized that if they can seize the opportunity presented by this transformation at an early stage, they will gain an important first mover advantage and retain a competitive edge for years to come. The world won't wait. If the travel and tourism industry does not take advantage of this opportunity, it will lag behind and in the long term suffer from lower economic growth. However, if the opportunity is grasped, the rewards may be many. No sector of the economy or area of government policy will remain unaffected by the transformation. Our world is changing and we need to adapt to these changes. If we don't grasp new opportunities, but stick to our old ways, we will pay the price of low growth and a suffering environment in a future which is closer than one might think. This is why we need to seize the opportunity today and lay the basis for future prosperity and healthy environment by leading the conversion to the eco-efficient economy. I count on you in this challenge because we need to do this for ourselves, for the environment, but also and foremost the coming generation. Thank you very much.